In 1990, the federation of six republics that made up Yugoslavia was still united. But with the collapse of communism, the two major republics, Serbia and Croatia, fell under the sway of rival nationalisms. Serbia's president, Slobodan Milosevic, had been the first to inflame his people. The Serb threat provoked the people of neighboring Croatia to respond. In their first free elections, they chose the nationalist, Franjo Tudjman, as their president.
Danas je Krist triumfalno ušao u Jeruzalem, dočekan I pozdravljen od naroda kao Mesija. I glavni grad Hrvatske danas liči na Jeruzalem. Franjo Tudjman dolazi pred građane.
Mislim da je u tom vremenu trebalo daleko više suptilnosti, posebno kad se znalo da smo I one Srbe koji su bili za dogovor, koji su bili za Hrvatsku, dobijali protiv sebe.
The bleak land of southern Croatia was home to large numbers of Serbs. It was here that the fuse was lit that would lead the whole of Yugoslavia to ignite. In the dusty railway town of Knin, the authority of President Tudjman's newly elected government was rejected by the local police, who were mostly Serbs.
Inspektor Martić da rekao da je ovo narodna milicija I da ne sluša hrvatsku vladu, nego samo ovaj narod. E protiv te hrvatske vlade koja nam stvara zlo. Tako glasno, jasno. Eto. To reci Mile Martić, onaj što se pisao, to sam ja. Tako kažeš da, da sam rekao.
Pa bilo je jasno dato do znanja da milicija u Hrvatskoj odnosno milicionari srpske nacionalnosti, da će morati da prihvate obilježja, simbole koje su bile za vreme zloglasne NDH države.
Serbs had raw memories of the last nationalists to rule Croatia. They were Hitler's allies, and under the checkerboard flag they killed hundreds of thousands of Serbs. Tudjman's embrace of the checkerboard flag was like waving the Nazi swastika in their faces. When Tudjman sent his police ministers down to Knin to deal with the rebel police, the local mayor, a Serb dentist, prepared a reception committee.
Nemojte praviti gužvu pred vratima. Pređite na drugu stranu ulice. Pređite na drugu stranu.
Ja sam tada preko puta milicijske stanice u bašti kafića sazvao aktiviste svoje stranke I naredio im da se narod okupi.
Inside the police station, the Croat minister tried a conciliatory line with his employees.
Molim policiji, svaki čovjek ima pravo na svoje političko mišljenje.
Nakon ti moje riječi uslijedila je jedna reakcija koja je bila vrlo ružna od strane skupine koju je vodio Mile Martić.
Pa Perica Jurić je u početku bio prilično drzak I bezobrazan.
Prema tome, iza potpisnika pisma ne stoji 50 potpisa, nego stoji srpski narod. Stoji ovaj narod koji ovdje se okuplja I čeka rezultat ovih razgovora.
Tada nisam vidio u životu čovjeka koji se toliko preplašio kao on. Mislim da je u roku pola sata 10 puta odlazio u WC, najvjerovatnije dobio proliv ili nešto slično.
A izvana je par tisuća ljudi je na cesti oko zgrade, jel? To je vriska, galama, jel? I veli mi Joža, kaže, Boga li ti tvoga državu im obeća I samo da žive glave izvučem odavde, jel? Jer je bio ambijent predvješan.
Sa sastanka su otišli uz našu pomoć. Mi smo ih bukvalno izvukli, rekli smo narodu da ih ne dira. a poslije toga oni više nisu imali nikakvu vlast u Kninu.
The police chief and the dentist tried to turn the protest into a full-scale rebellion.
Ja sam dobio zaduženje da se spremam i na oružani otpor i da od Jugoslavije dobijemo pomoć ili u oružju ili da tadašnja Jugoslavenska narodna armija bude ta koja će zaštititi ovaj narod.
For a Serb revolt to be successful, it needed support from Belgrade, the capital of both Yugoslavia and Serbia. The president of Serbia, Slobodan Milosevic, was happy to stoke the flames of unrest in Croatia. The rebel mayor of Knin became a frequent visitor. Milosevic turned the request for military support over to his closest colleague.
Mene je zvao Slobodan Milošević i tražio je da ja hitno primim Srbe iz Hrvatske, koji su tražili kod mene razgovor kao predsjednika predsjedništva Jugoslavije.
That year, Serbia held the chairmanship of the Yugoslav State Council, the body which gave orders to the army. The Serbs from Knin had found a well-placed ally.
Tražili su se nešto uradi jer se približava vreme nezavisne države Hrvatske i čitave politike koju Pavelić vodio prema srpskom narodu, jer je i on počeo od ugrožavanja nacionalnih prava do genocida. Bili su jako uplašeni.
The man in charge of law and order in Yugoslavia, another Serb, advised the visitors from Knin on how to run their rebellion.
Praviti barikade, i to sam ih učio. I noću da čuvaju stražu, ko ima šta, ko nema oružje, ima lovačko. Nešto mora da čuje, znači da se čuva straža, nekoliko meštana, da budu budni stalno, da ne bi upali ustaše.
Iako nije bilo konkretnih obećanja od gospodina Jovića, osjećao sam da bi na neki način moglo da nam se pomogne.
Armed with more than advice, the Serbs from Knin organized roadblocks. Belgrade television was quick to play on the fears of their Serb brothers in Croatia.
3:30. Nalazimo se na poziciji na kojoj stražu čuva.
Narod pomalo, kako da kažem, preplašen i ljudi čuvaju stražu da bi zaštitili svoje živote, jer poučeni su nekim iskustvima iz prošlosti koje su se desili. I nastoje da se to nešto ne ponovi sada u ovo vreme.
Djevojke u ljetnim haljinama vole. Djevojke u ljetnim haljinama vole.
The crisis in Knin came at the height of the tourist season.
We think the scenery is absolutely superb and Yugoslavian people are so friendly.
Tourism, a vital source of Croat government revenue, was under threat. And the Serb minority in Croatia had blocked the key road and rail links from the Croat capital, Zagreb, to the sea. In the Croat town of Split, where the European Athletics Championships were about to begin, President Tudjman faced a dilemma. Should he act against the rebellious Serbs? If he did, would the Yugoslav federal authorities intervene?
Ja sam tada bio u Splitu i naredio sam nekim ljudima u Ministarstvu unutarnjih poslova da sa specijalnim odredom uđu u Knin i da razoružaju Martića.
On mi je rekao, kaže, izvoli, uzmi helikopter i izvoli otići u Knin. To je nadležnost Ministarstva unutrašnjih poslova, izvoli se pojavi dolje, izvoli napraviti sve da se uvede red i mir.
The minister was uneasy. The rebellion in Knin was spreading. And he knew its leaders were backed by Belgrade.
I autonomiji srpskog naroda.
Ja sam mu kazao, ali sigurno će nas zaustaviti armija. Kaže, neka se usude samo.
Three police helicopters took off from the Croat capital, Zagreb, informing air traffic control they were carrying equipment to the coast. In fact, they were crammed with Croat special forces, ready to join ground units in an attack on the rebel Serbs. 10 minutes after takeoff, air traffic control alerted the Yugoslav army that the helicopters were on course for Knin.
Prenijeto je iz generalštaba, rekli su mi da im prenesem i da im praktično zahtevamo da ih vrate, ako i ne vrate helikoptere, da ih oborimo.
U niskom letu su išli iznad nas, jeli, da bi nam dali do znanja koliko smo sitne ribe. Jeli. I u jednom momentu se javlja taj pilot koji je decidirano izjavio, veli, ili se vratite nazad u bazu ili vas rušimo. Mi smo tada okrenuli, ova dvojica se okrenula i vratili smo se u Zagreb.
President Tudjman was now sure that the challenge from the Serbs in Knin was more than a local squabble.
Mi smo bili suočeni, znači, sa jednim unapred određenim programom kako da se podigne pobuna protiv demokratske vlasti.
Zove me Tudjman telefonom iz Zagreba, sav uzbuđen, i kaže: ovo je katastrofa. Nama ne daju da vršimo legalno izabranu vlast. Je li smo mi legalno izabrana vlast ili se nas ovdje hoće srušiti, ne znam u čemu se radi. Sve se to diktira iz Beograda, sve se to sprema u Beogradu.
Oni su to odbili i ispričavajući se da, da vojska da nije dala nikakav nalog za sprečavanje hrvatskih helikoptera, nego da je to bilo zbog tehničkih razloga oko dozvole prilijetanja itd. No, nama je bilo jasno o čemu je riječ.
Round one to the Serbs. The Serbs in Knin now declared their mini Serbia a no-go area for Croats. Croat TV dubbed the rebellion the revolution of the logs and tried to laugh it off as the work of a few drunken Serbs. This was no joke for a president who had been elected to restore Croatia's pride. The Yugoslav army had humiliated him, and he had no means to respond.
Zbog toga sam ja otišao kod predsjednika Tudjmana i rekao da mi ne imamo više šta čekati, da očigledno, a ja sam to i očekivao, armija neće naoružavati našu policiju, a ona je prema zakonu bila dužna to činiti, nego da moramo to učiniti sami. On se s tim saglasio.
This retired Yugoslav army general had got himself a secret mission. At first, he ran into problems.
They approached us about supplying them with arms. They said they wanted to improve their police techniques and their police force. And I have to say, I did not hesitate a nanosecond before I recommended to Washington that we turn them down. We certainly did not want to be arming a Croatian police force so it could oppress Serbs.
The Croats took their business elsewhere.
Ja sam posjetio Budimpeštu i da smo tamo u dogovoru sa odgovarajućim organima Mađarske napravili ugovor o isporuci naoružanja. Kada smo mi Eurocheckom zagarantirali plaćanje, mi smo poslali tamo dva šlepera.
The two lorries, loaded with Kalashnikovs, arrived at the Hungarian-Croat border in the early hours. Someone had been tipped off.
Ja sam se isto nalazio na tom prelazu i osmatrali smo iz onog pojasa gde se vojska nalazi sa jedne osmatračnice. Mi u stvari nismo znali precizno da se radi o uvozu oružja. Mi smo znali za nešto tajno što se dešava na granici i propušta mimo kontrole, u čemu učestvuju čelni ljudi ovaj sud.
The lorries disappeared into the night. Yugoslav military intelligence now began a major operation to prove who was behind the smuggling.
Počeli su da nam postavljaju zasjede. Počeli su ispitivati u Budimpešti i tako dalje. Vrlo agresivno su nastupili prema Hrvatskoj.
Rekao sam tim ljudima po prilici. Ako ne možemo avionom, ne možemo brodom, ne možemo vlakom, ne možemo kamionom, možemo li mravima? Nastala je konsternacija u dvorani. Kakvi mravi? Četvrtotkaši, mali. Shvatili su svi. I krenulo je. Bilo je sitnih zapljena. Ali, Boga mi je dosta i došlo toga.
Only the army of the Yugoslav Federation was capable of stopping the Croats. A display of force had been enough to turn back the Croat helicopters bound for Knin. Now, the Yugoslav High Command faced the fact that the government of Croatia was equipping itself to form a rival army.
Zakonsku obavezu imao, jer je to uvoženje oružja da bi se izvršila oružana pobuna protiv međunarodno pravno priznate države, koja je međunarodno pravni faktor, koja ima svoj ustav.
But these arms smugglers were the democratically elected government of Croatia. It would be politically dangerous to arrest them. The army trod carefully. At the beginning of January 1991, an order was issued aimed at the Croats. All illegally held weapons must be handed in within 10 days. Croat ministers were openly defiant.
Pa gospodo, zar vi mislite kad pojedine policijske stanice, pojedine općine otkazuju lojalnost Republici Hrvatskoj, da ćemo mi onda kupiti dva šlepera naliv pera da bi pisali nemojte nas napadati? Moramo poručiti gospodinu Martiću da će hrvatski barjak doći u Knin i hrvatski grb da će doći u Knin.
Mesić then phoned Belgrade to tell the Serb leadership what his government would do if an attempt was made to disarm them by force.
Mesić je rekao da ukoliko se to ne prihvati što on traži, onda će uraditi sljedeće. Tačno od A do Š da zapišem, da slučajno ne ispadne da mi nije rekao. Prvo, proglasit će odcepljenje. Drugo, zatražit će od Savjeta bezbednosti intervenciju mirovnim snagama da njih zaštiti od nas, iako se oni naoružavaju protiv sopstvene države. Treće, povući će sve kadrove iz organa federacije. Pitao sam ga da li su svjesni da su odabrali rat.
Fear swept the Croat capital, Zagreb, that the Yugoslav army was about to move. Crowds prayed for peace. President Tudjman called an emergency session of his parliament.
Prvo. Svaki čin pravnog ili fizičkog nasilja koji bi bio suprotan Ustavu Republike Hrvatske smatrat ćemo ugrožavanjem ustavnog poretka Hrvatske, pa bi se svaka represivna akcija smatrala činom okupacije.
During the session, an invitation arrived. Tudjman was asked to go to Belgrade to face the Yugoslav leadership and the army.
Ljudi su me i sa suzama u očima iz prijateljskog kruga i drugi uvjeravali baš u parlamentu da ne idem.
Rumors spread that if they went to Belgrade, Tuđman and his ministers would be arrested.
A osim toga, nema drugom, ni onima nasuprot nama, ni nama nego da razgovaramo i tražimo rješenje. Čak sam smatrao intimno u sebi, ukoliko bi me ubili, da bi to bilo pred svijetom upravo dokaz toga da idu protiv hrvatske slobode, protiv hrvatske demokracije, prema tome u interesu Hrvatske. I zbog toga sam otišao.
The State Council, Yugoslavia's highest authority, was the body which could give the order for the army to act against Croatia. That evening, they met in Belgrade to deal with Croatia's refusal to hand over weapons. Every republic had a vote.
Mesić je apsolutno odbio bilo kakvu aktivnost koju možemo učiniti, a i drugi članovi predsjedništva su bili u velikoj nedoumici šta da se radi, jer kao što se zna, to je bio trenutak kada treba povesti vojnu akciju.
The State Council members, waiting for the Croat president to arrive, argued on. The head of the Yugoslav military then made a seemingly innocent request. It was a trap.
Nekoliko minuta prije pola osam, kad su inače bile vijesti, general Kadijević je predložio jednu stanku da bi bilo dobro vidjeti vijesti, pa onda da nastavimo s radom.
Like the rest of the country, the State Council found themselves watching a TV program shot, as the caption says, on VHS without the knowledge of its participants. The film showed the chief Croat arms buyer talking about what it called terrorist formations in Croatia.
Ima ukupno na petoj armijskoj ulazi 9000 rešina.
Da.
To je kući i vojne službenike i militare kraje. To je 9000. I 18000 vojnika. Na cijeloj teritoriji, petova, znači Slovenija, cijela Hrvatska i deo Bosne. A mi imamo sad naoružani 80000 za Kalašnikovim.
Yugoslav military intelligence, who made the film, intercut the material with public statements by President Tuđman.
A što se tiče naoružanja, nismo naoružavali HDZ-ovce.
Vi niste u toku onda, ljudi moji, pa mi smo s njima na ratu. I po ratu s njima.
S kim?
Sa vojskom.
The Serb chairman quietly reveled in the discomfort of his Croat colleague.
Nisu prosto mogli svojim očima da veruju kako je to moglo sve da se snimi u kancelarijama u kojima su se oni dogovarali, ne dogovarali, u kojima su govorili o stravičnim zločinima koje žele da vrše.
Ja sam polazio od toga da je to sve montaža, da eventualno možda ima nešta i istinitih snimaka, ali da je to sve s jednom tehnikom moguće učiniti.
Odjednom su rekli da je to čisto montaža sa kojom se želi srušiti hrvatska vlast, a u stvari su uhvaćeni na delu.
When President Tuđman finally joined the meeting, instead of responding to the film, he issued a warning to the defense minister, General Kadijević.
Prema tome da bi na njemu osobno bila odgovornost za krvoproliće u Hrvatskoj, za obaranje hrvatske vlasti.
Njegovim se dolaskom atmosfera nije poboljšala uopšte. Cele noći je drama bila, svak svakoga je optuživao.
Kadijević meni rekao kao je treba da baci na koljena Tuđmana i to HDZ rukovodstvo, jer je to u toj mjeri očevidno da oni na jedan krvav način žele da izvrše razračun u Jugoslaviji, da to ne može proći, a da ne bude u javnosti u Hrvatskoj.
That night, the army's tactic appeared to work. Isolated in the Serb capital, the Croat leaders caved in. Tuđman was forced to give a promise. He would allow the Yugoslav army to arrest those implicated in smuggling arms. He got back to Zagreb in the early hours, exhausted. Uncertain how his people would react, he did not tell anxious reporters about his promise.
Da će sada naši ljudi u Hrvatskoj moći mirno spavati, da ćemo se moći posvetiti drugim poslovima, a ne se pribojavati da ćemo
noću ili ujutro biti iznenađeni tenkovima, vojnim motorom i tako dalje.
When Tudjman woke up, he found his people's fear had given way to celebration. Safe on home ground, Tudjman withdrew the promise he had made in Belgrade. Instead of helping the army arrest the culprits, he passed a law giving his ministers immunity. The chief arms smuggler himself appeared on Croat television to answer the question, was the film a forgery?
Gledali smo jednu konstrukciju, jedan falsifikat.
On leaving the studio, the general immediately set out to discover who had given him away.
Martin me sreo i rekao mi, kaže, samo su dvojica ljudi me mogla u sve ovo uvaliti. Ko su ta dvojica ljudi? Kaže, to je jedan kome vjerujem beskonačno. A velim, ko je drugi? Drugi sam ja. Kaže, tako je.
The general had been filmed while trying to persuade two Yugoslav army officers to steal arms for Croatia.
Grupa koja je bila okupljena je bila zaista od visokog mog povjerenja. Ja evo sad mogu da kažem da sam imao neograničeno povjerenje prema Jagaru.
But one of them, though a Croat and a family friend, put Yugoslavia first. He had hidden a video camera inside his television set.
Tako da nije dobro nekad nemat ljude kojima beskonačno vjerujete oko sebe u takvim poslovima.
Croat TV mocked the impotence of the Serbs, Milosevic, Jovic and the Yugoslav defense minister with their motley crew of Serb nationalists. The Croats had got away with it. President Milosevic now declared himself the guardian of Yugoslavia. He persuaded the generals that the only way to save the Federation was to mobilize the army to disarm the Croats. But the generals needed an order from the State Council, representing all the republics. To persuade the State Council would require the skills of a Machiavelli. A demonstration in the center of Belgrade, his own capital, provided Milosevic with a chance to show how the army could be used. The demonstrators, demanding press freedom in Serbia, gathered in the spring sunshine.
Ljudi su bili krajnje mirni, bilo je dosta burnih izliva emocija, bilo je dosta skandiranja, uzvika. Međutim, ljudi su mirno stajali i slušali govornike.
Milosevic chose to see it otherwise.
Zvao me prvo Milošević i rekao mi je da je čitav haos. I sam je govorio o tome da bi možda bilo potrebno da vojska pomogne.
Borisav Jović, the most trusted ally of President Milosevic, was still chairman of the council which controlled the army. He began to work the phones.
Very, very soon after the beginning of the demonstration in Belgrade, Jović called me.
To je oko podne. Negde. Negde između 11 i 12 možda.
He was telling me, Vasil, this is a matter of historic vote. We have to block this because a war will erupt. This is a completely illegal action. It is meant to destabilize Serbia and Yugoslavia, that the army has to act.
Vasil Tupakovsky was surprised because the demonstration he saw on television, though massive, was peaceful. he refused to vote for bringing in the army. Soon after this, the Serb police were sent in.
Negdje na polovini govora gospodina Paroškog, odjednom u sredinu te gomile doleteo je jedan suzavac i ljudi su prosto počeli spontano da beže. S obzirom da je policija bila skroz okolo demonstranata, logično je bilo da na tim krajevima dođe do sukoba demonstranata i policije.
The Serb leaders had first asked for tanks to be put on the streets 3 hours earlier. Now their case was stronger.
Finally, about 6 o'clock in the evening, when Jović called me for the seventh or eighth time, I told them, okay, I will vote yes, because I saw that there are casualties. Others will come for sure. Everything was getting out of control. It was obvious. We were watching the television.
Nazvao sam članove predsjedništva koji su mi dali saglasnost da će vojska u stvari prošetati kroz Beograd i odvratiti demonstrate od vandalizma.
Now the Yugoslav army chief of staff phoned the Serb police minister. This is a recording of what he said.
Znamo da bi sve svoje snage kad se vojska pojavi treba da krenu akciju da biju do iznemoglosti. Bez upotrebe oružja, da prate vojsku i da biju tamo i da biju na drugim pravcima. Da se jednostavno napravi jedna akcija juriša u kojoj treba da se bije bez nemogućnosti.
Within the hour, Milosevic appeared on television to justify the intervention of the Yugoslav army.
Danas je u Srbiji, u Beogradu, napadnuta najveća vrednost koju ima naša zemlja i naš narod. Ugrožen je mir. Zato se snagama haosa i bezumlja Srbija mora suprotstaviti svim ustavnim sredstvima i zato tražim.
Milosevic had got the tanks out of the barracks once. Now he could take the next step towards deploying them in Croatia. It all began with a television announcement.
Watching television at about 11 o'clock, even maybe even midnight, something like that. All of a sudden the program was interrupted and we saw Jović.
U tim okolnostima, na zahtev...
The Serb chairman of the State Council, the collective presidency of Yugoslavia, startled his fellow council members.
He tells the members of the presidency on television that we have a meeting of the presidency as a supreme command. The next day, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock in Belgrade.
The Slovene representative was too frightened to come. The Croat, though fearing arrest, believed he had to attend to talk his colleagues round.
Pri dolasku u zgradu predsjedništva dočekali su nas vojni autobusi sa predstavnicima vojske koji su rekli da će sjednica biti u vrhovnoj komandi.
Colonel came up to us and he showed very dramatically and orderly that we have to enter the bus.
To je jedna predigra, da je to pokušaj u stvari stvaranje impresije jakosti vojske, ozbiljnosti situacije.
Message was very afraid. You could notice that immediately, you know, all set up like that in the back.
Only the Serb chairman and the Minister of Defense knew what was going on as the other members filed in.
We entered the meeting room. It was very cold. I would say not more than 14. The presidency was there trembling before the military. The camera was on. It was never before we saw a camera.
Cameras recorded every word. All part of the army's plan to intimidate the State Council. The Serb chairman called on the Minister of Defense, General Kadjevic.
Na djelu je perfidan i do kraja razrađen koncept razbijanja Jugoslavije. Da se izazivanjem građanskog rata stvore uslovi za spoljnu intervenciju i definitivnu uspostavu marionetskih režima na prostoru Jugoslavije.
The Minister of Defense then proposed the immediate declaration of a nationwide state of emergency.
The army proposal was given in a form to that you cannot turn it down. It was the responsibility of the presidency to save the country from civil war. This was the explanation. And to most of us, it was clear that truly that kind of situation existed.
The Croat would have none of it.
Serbia može biti velika, ali te prostore mora osvojiti armija. Ona ne može do hrvatskih prostora doći bez armije, a to je rat.
Ja sam ga uvijek pokušavao kao i sve njih razuvjeriti, htio sam ih vratiti u realnost, htio sam mu pokazati da nije krivnja na Hrvatskoj.
Sada donijeti odluku da suspendujete sve to što je zakon i što ste naredbu donijeli. Izvolite. Izvolite.
The moment of decision had come. The Serb chairman needed the support of 5 of the 8 voting members. He turned first to a reliable ally.
The vote was yes by Kostic. I said next to him second, and I said no. Message was next to me as vice president. He said no. And then Jović, yes. And Bučin, yes. So it was 3-2 when the vote came to Sapunđiju.
Da li si ti dobio dovoljno odgovora ili još da odgovara?
Dobro.
Dobro, znači prihvataš.
So they had the 4 votes already and they needed the 5th vote.
Bogić, izvoli.
Imam odgovornost da ne dođe do građanskog rata i mislim da ga moramo spriječiti svaku cijenu.
Everything now hung on the vote of Bosnia's representative. With a mixed population of Muslims, Serbs and Croats, Bosnia had most to lose if Yugoslavia descended into civil war.
The pressure on Bogićević was tremendous. He was a Serbian, but representing Bosnia and Herzegovina. And a very much orientated towards Yugoslavia.
Tu su Jović i drugi očekivali da se ja ponašam na sjednici predsjedništva isključivo kao Srbin.
Spreman sam da svaki dan analiziramo stanje i da svaki dan donosimo odluku. Nemam mnogo logike u tome što govoriš, ali ne bih želio da govoriš.
Jović started shouting, vote, what is the problem? Vote yes, vote no, but vote, Bogić, vote.
Kod izjašnjavanja Bogića Bogićevića nastala je mrtva tišina.
Sada mislim da ne bi bilo produktivno
zaključujem sjednicu.
Bosnia had stymied both the army and the Serbs. But nearby, in the Serb presidential palace, Slobodan Milosevic was ahead of the game. He announced that Serbia and her allies were withdrawing from the State Council.
Predsjedništvo SFRJ odavno ne funkcioniše. A iluzija o nastojanjima predsjedništva Jugoslavije i naporima kojih u stvari nema, od noćas je definitivno mrtva. To nije korak nazad, već korak napred, jer je i gruba istina bolja od iluzija i obmana.
Milosevic was trying to destroy the supreme authority in Yugoslavia, which controlled the army high command.
Armija može da kaže, pošto nemamo vrhovnog komandanta, a mi smo prisiljeni da sami takvu odluku donesemo i da te paravojne jedinice suzbijemo. To je bilo naša formula.
Milosevic and Jović were seeking to give the army a free hand to launch war on Croatia. But they were unsure how the West would react.
Američki ambasador Zimmerman tražio zvanično prijem kod mene.
What I said to Jović was that we were very anxious that force not be used in Croatia.
Oni faktički se slažu sa stvaranjem paravojnih jedinica kojima legalna država ne može ništa.
He said to me, Mr. Zimmerman, he said, and I think he shook his fist at this point, that Mr. Zimmerman, he said, how many armies does the United States have? How can you tolerate having more than one army in your country? How can you expect us not to react when the Croats are trying to build their own army?
Ali se iz toga vidi već najava zvaničnog pritiska najveće svjetske sile na našu državu, na našu vlast.
The Serbs looked to a traditional ally.
Ja mislim da ovo do sada nije ni objavljeno, nikada i nigde. Mi smo se tada konsultovali, Kadijević i ja, da izvršimo određenu konsultaciju u Rusiji.
In Moscow, the general met secretly with the hardline communists who ran the Soviet Ministry of Defense.
Dogovorili smo se da on postavi pitanje, ako mi izvršimo nasilno oduzimanje oružja Hrvatima i ako zapadne zemlje izvrše vojnu intervenciju, da li će nas Rusi zaštititi?
The Soviet defense minister gave General Kadijević details of their intelligence reports. These showed the Yugoslav army was safe to ignore Western warnings.
Nije to znao niko, ni jedan član predsjedništva, ni niko, apsolutno samo ja. To su naše interne stvari, mi radimo ono što imamo pravo. To su informativne stvari koje nisu nikakve odluke.
Confident they could act in safety, Milosevic and Jović went to the Yugoslav army headquarters for the launch of the military action they had planned together.
Većina strateškog kadra i vojničkog kadra i naroda, naročito ovih delova ovde, sada u Saveznoj Republici Jugoslaviji, priželjkivali su da dođe do vanrednih mera i da vojska preuzme stvar u svoje ruke.
Just five days earlier at the State Council, the Minister of Defense, General Kadijević, had made his intentions clear.
Ja ću vam reći da će i bez tih
But now, when the time came to act, his fellow conspirators were in for a shock. General Kadijević hesitated.
I vojska je onda, kao što sam vam rekao, procenila da bi to bilo smatrano kao vojni udar, da bi to niko ne bi iz međunarodne zajednice priznao i da bi to vodilo u potpuno suprotnom pravcu nego što bi bilo rješenje za krizu u Jugoslaviji.
On je van sumnje želio Jugoslaviju po svaku cijenu braniti i tako dalje, ali to da istupi sa oružanim snagama, sa armijom, da to učini, to on nikada u svojoj svijesti i u svom načinu razmišljanja uopće nije mogao akceptirati.
Yugoslavia's senior general had dashed Milosevic's plan. Within weeks, President Tudjman was openly flaunting his new weapons. Croatia had chosen the path to independence.
Ustati na noge kao jedan, ako će tu suverenost trebati braniti.
Milosevic seemed to accept the inevitable. He called a summit with Tudjman to work out how to carve up Yugoslavia between them. But the Serb leader had other plans.
Smatrao je da treba to da nas ozbiljno upozori da mi svoju taktiku prilagodimo. Treba vojsku tamo rasporediti oko srpskih prostora, prepustiti Hrvatima da izazovu sukobe I onda zadržati te teritorije.
The Republic of Croatia declares itself independent from Yugoslavia and pleads for the world's recognition.
Pozivamo sve vlade I parlamente svih država da prihvate I priznaju čin slobodne odluke hrvatskog naroda, čin slobode kojim još jedan narod hoće postati punopravnim članom Međunarodne zajednice slobodnog svijeta.
Behind their smiles, Croatia's leaders were nervous. They feared that Serbia, the biggest Yugoslav republic, would crush them. The Serb president asserted his legitimate interest in Croatia.
E io ebbi un colloquio a quattro occhi con Milosevic, che ricordo molto bene. In cui lui mi disse la Croazia non può andarsene senza negoziare con noi perché in Croazia ci sono 600.000 serbi.
Ako mi ne osporavamo pravo nijednom narodu da izađe iz Jugoslavije, nemoguće je osporiti pravo onim narodima koji žele da ostanu u svojoj postojećoj zemlji, u Jugoslaviji, da ostanu, da žive u Jugoslaviji.
E o ci lasciano I 600.000 serbi con il loro territorio, noi non consentiremo che loro se ne vadano in maniera tranquilla e normale.
Unlike Slovenia, Croatia had a large Serb minority. Here in Vukovar, near the border with Serbia, the real war in Yugoslavia would begin. Serb nationalists in Croatia had already seized power in a dozen villages. They wanted to link them up and expel the Croats who were in their way. Then this pure Serb mini-state could join the motherland, the first step to the creation of a new Yugoslavia, run by and for the Serbs. To this end, extremist allies of President Milosevic set about provoking a conflict between Serbs and Croats.
Ustaške horde atakuju na srpska sela, na srpske žene I decu. Ustaške horde nastoje da dovrše ono genocid nad srpskim narodom.
91. godine počinjemo masovnije da organizujemo dobrovoljce I da ih upućujemo na već formirane frontove, posebno u istočnu Slavoniju.
Ranjena su...
The man whose job it was to stop such intrusions was the police chief of eastern Croatia, Josip Rajkulkir. He commanded 1,000 armed men, Croatia's only military force there. But Kier refused to take the path of confrontation. He did all he could to make sure Serbs and Croats went on living together.
Redovno sam se viđao sa Josipom. Gde god bi Srbi postavili barikadu, Rajkulkir bi odlazio tamo autom, uvek nenaoružan, izlazio bi, otvarao bi sako I govorio. Nenaoružan sam, ubeđivao ih I u najvećem broju slučajeva bi uspeo da ih ubedi odmah da tu barikadu uklone.
But the police chief had an opponent in the local party leader. The nationalist wing in Croatia's ruling party was as extreme as any in Serbia.
Došla delegacija iz Zagreba, koji je bio prisutan I glavaš, I zatražili od njega da ih odvede u Borovo selo.
Borovo selo is a suburb of Vukovar, the main city on Croatia's bank of the Danube. It was a prime target for the Serb nationalists. In the center, the population was a mix of Croats and Serbs. But the suburb was mostly Serb, and the extremists set up barricades to keep Croats out.
On ih je tamo odveo, izašao iz auta, magla je bila. Otvorili su prtežnik, izvadili iz prtežnika ambrustere. Josip je samo gledao zbunjeno. I ispalili tri granate pravcu Borova sela. Prva granata je pogodila tanjuraču, tu barikadu nazovimo. Druga je otišla u kukuruzište, a treća u zid prve kuće u selu.
This act of provocation was committed by some of President Tudjman's closest political partners. Other members of his cabinet soon found out.
Kir je posle svega toga došao kod mene I rekao mi. U grupi za Borovo selo bio je gospodin Sušak, sadašnji ministar obrane, bio je Vice Vukojević, tada pomoćnik ministra unutrašnjih poslova.
Shushak, recently returned from exile in Canada, was leader of the party's extreme wing. His midnight rocket attack did not cow his Serb victims in Vukovar. They turned to Belgrade for protection.
Borovo selo je tražilo da jedan broj naših dobrovoljaca tamo postavimo da budu u stalnom obezbeđenju. Oružje smo dobijali od Miloševićeve policije.
The Serbs in the Vukovar suburb seized two Croat policemen. The Croats hit back.
Došli su svojim autobusima u centar sela, Hrvati.
Two buses of heavily armed Croat police drove confidently into the Serb stronghold, straight into an ambush.
I bilo je dakle kritično ti prvi pola sata otpora koji su pružili naši dobrovoljci, dok se celo selo diglo na oružje I onda su Hrvati bitku izgubili.
12 Croat policemen were killed, 22 wounded. That night, Croatia exploded with fury. Crowds burned the Yugoslav flags they saw as a symbol of Serbia.
Što se tiče situacije u kojoj smo našli, Ministarstvo unutrašnjih poslova naredit će mobilizaciju rezervnog sastava u kriznim područjima. Mi ćemo znati obraniti svaki pedalj hrvatske zemlje.
As Croatia and Serbia slid towards war, the extremists took charge. The war party close to President Tudjman were determined to put an end to the peacekeeping of their own police chief, Rajkulkir. They set out to get rid of him.
Bio je u Zagrebu kod svog ministra Boljkovca I rekao mu da nema više kuda, da je gotov.
Onda mi je između oslog rekao, ministre, pomognite mi, ja ću biti ubijen, povucite me u Zagreb. Ja ću raditi sve, reko Kir, pa nemojte biti dijete, popili smo viski, pa neće biti tako. Ja vas molim, spašavajte me. I na to dođe k meni, a ko će vas? Pa veli, slušajte, on je spomenuo Glavaša Vukojevića i spomenuo u Zagrebu vrh koji je bio ministar Suška i ovih, jel?
The police minister agreed to transfer Chief Kier to the capital, but on the day he was to leave, there was another incident. Kier drove out one last time to calm the situation. He was lured to one of his own police checkpoints. The commander was curiously missing, and a member of the ruling party, a Croat named Gudel, blocked his way.
Nih je zaustavljao, niti pokušao zaustaviti, nego je ispalio cijeli šanžer na auto. Suprug moj je dobio 16 metaka. To mu je bila nagrada za sve mjesece rada i zalaganja. Je bio u rezervnom sastavu policije i da bude apsurd veći, par dana prije je došao kod Josipa po naoružanje i Josip je zadužio mu kalašnjikov. I sa tim kalašnjikovim ga je ubio.
Two days later, a column of tanks, 20 miles long, set off from Belgrade to the Croat border. They flew the Yugoslav flag, but increasingly, this was the army of the Serb president, Milosevic. They claimed they were neutral peacekeepers and that the Serbs in the Croatian countryside needed their protection. The Serb media backed them up. One of the army officers sent to protect the Serbs was Colonel Mladic, later to command the army of the Serbs in Bosnia.
U službi otadžbine Socijalističke federativne republike Jugoslavije sa mojim drugovima, starešinama i svih, iz redova svih naroda i narodnosti i sa svojim vojnicima.
But the Croats didn't find the colonel as even-handed as he claimed when he arrived at a small village called Kijevo.
Kijevo je bilo hrvatsko selo, a iza Kijeva su bila srpska sela koji su bili blokirani. Hrvati preko Kijeva nisu dozvoljavali da bilo kakva pomoć stigne za ta srpska sela. Tada sam se odlučio da dam jedan ultimatum Kijevu.
The ultimatum was addressed to the Kijevo police, who were Croats like the rest of the villagers. It demanded that the police quit their post. When they refused, Colonel Mladic ordered the regular Yugoslav army into action. It was the first time they had brazenly fought for the Serb cause. They pounded the Croats into submission.
U Kijevu, otićete i tamo. Tučena je svaka kuća vatrom i svih sredstava jedinice iz koje je pružan otpor. Nije tučen ni jedan cilj, niti je tučena ni jedna kuća da bi se kuća srušila.
Once the army was done, the local Serbs walked in.
Čini mi se da smo bili mnogo nadmoćniji u odnosu na Hrvate. Naravno, nekoliko kuća se u tom obračunu zapalilo, već kako to ide od artiljerije.
The Yugoslav flag was raised as the army seized Croat town after Croat town. The Serbs had the heavy guns, but they also had a problem. Every big town in Croatia had a Yugoslav army barracks. The Croats besieged them. But they only had a puny army. So President Tudjman carefully picked his spot to make a stand.
Braneći Vukovar, mi smo branili Vinkovce i Osijek. Jer da su Srbi uspjeli da laganije i brže osvoje Vukovar, to bi onda za Hrvatsko bilo znatno nepovoljnije. Zbog toga smo mi angažirali sve tada raspoložive snage.
At Vukovar, Yugoslavia's conscript army was hit with a rash of desertions. Milosevic had to bolster his forces with gangs of nationalist thugs.
Ovo je najjače ustaško uporište. Kad padne Vukovar, ustaše nemaju šansi. Razume se, onaj koji je došao ovdje dobrovoljno da se bori, taj zna zbog čega je došao i zašto se bori. Njega ne treba ubeđivati da ide u borbu. Vrlo brzo smo stekli to povjerenje i onda nam je režim dao i kasarnu u Bubanj potoku. Čitava jedna kasarna je bila samo za dobrovoljce Srpske radikalne stranke. I mi smo dobrovoljce okupljali u Beogradu, tu smo dobijali uniforme za njih, oružje za njih, autobuse za prebacivanje na frontove itd.
The paramilitaries range from criminal gangs to fanatical believers in the Serb cause.
Šta smo mi?
Tamo sam, naravno, pokušao prvo da budem politički vođa ili nekakav ideološki savjetnik, ali se to vrlo brzo pretvorilo u direktno vodstvo, jer svaki drugi izbor bi bio kukavičluk, a to je valjda najstrašnija osobina u vremenu rata od nekog ko se smatra nacionalistom.
Balkan's Serb paramilitaries seized the village of Vočin in eastern Croatia. 1,500 people lived there. When Croat soldiers retook the village, this is what they found. Bokan's men had killed 48 Croat civilians, shot them in the face and eyes, hit them with axes, or burnt them alive, and left them on display as a message to other Croats.
Važno je znati da li si izgubio ili si pobedio. Da li si heroj ili si na strani poraženih. Da li si jezikom međunarodne javnosti zločinac ili si junak. Da li si neko koga slavi tvoj narod ili neko zbog toga tvoj narod odlazi uz begove i beži sa svoje zemlje.
The terror was calculated to drive out whole populations. It was here it became known as ethnic cleansing. The Serbs were the chief perpetrators, but not the only ones. These women and children are Croats. This old man, a Serb. Both were from Vukovar, but moving in opposite directions. The European community had set a goal of 3 months to settle the crisis. 2 months had passed and the violence only worsened. Now all six Yugoslav republics were called to talks.
Mr. Chairman, Excellencies, the Yugoslav crisis, which is the reason for convening this conference, is the result of unilateral secessionist policy, first of Slovenia, then of Croatia.
Nema osnove za sprečavanje hrvatske samostalnosti pozivom na Jugoslavenski ustav iz 1974. jer je on narušen od Srbije ukidanjem autonomije.
Postojao je lijep scenario, ministri Europske 12-orice, čuvena lica koja su sjedila pored nas, a mi smo tamo negdje 6 posvađanih pripadnika jugoslovenskih plemena, gledali se sa više ili manje mržnje.
Having heard some of the remarks made this morning, it's quite clear that there are considerable difficulties ahead.
We decided to see the people who really mattered, President Milosevic and President Tudjman, and got them round the table and started talking to them about what the future setup should be.
Pa u tom razgovoru, kad je Milošević pokušao obnoviti tu ideju, ako su Hrvati imali pravo na samoodređenje, stvoriti samostalnu državu.
Ako je ravnopravan, šta onima drugima, to i njemu.
Onda i kninski Srbi imaju pravo na samoodređenje, da se priključe Srbiji.
Ravnopravan tretman, ravnopravan status, nemogućnost da bilo ko bude diskriminisan. To su bili razlozi i naše podrške našem narodu izvan Jugoslavije i izvan Srbije.
I talked to President Milošević and said, would you be perfectly prepared to, for example, to accept the independence of Croatia, subject, of course, to the human rights of the Serbs who live in Croatia. Would you be prepared to accept that? And he said yes. And I asked him several times, and he said yes.
Carrington set out to turn this verbal agreement into a plan for all Yugoslavia. But was Milosevic serious? Lord Carrington's bosses, the European Community foreign ministers, weren't sure.
Also, man sehr bald entstand der Eindruck, dass die Serben, die serbische Führung war es, auf Zeitgewinn arbeiteten, um den Krieg fortsetzen zu können.
The Germans had reasons for their doubt. Milosevic's generals, unimpressed by peace plans, had just begun shelling the ancient walled city of Dubrovnik. When Milosevic returned home, they offered him a quicker way to end the war.
Mi smo napravili planove i te smo planove trebali da ostvarimo. Da se sa dve kolone krene prema Zagrebu. Jedna podravskom magistralom, odnosno Podravinom, a drugi Posavinom. I mi bi za dva dana bili u Zagrebu i Hrvatske ne bi bilo ovako kako oni to traže.
Such an open campaign carried the risk of sanctions, or worse. Milosevic called in his war cabinet, both Serbs and their allies, the Montenegrins.
Postojala je mogućnost ili da prihvatimo plan koji nam je svijet ponudio po principu uzmi ili ostavi, ili je postojala mogućnost da objavimo rat čitavom svijetu.
I vrlo smo im otvoreno rekli, ako uđemo u tako veliki sukob sa Hrvatskom, ući ćemo u rat Nemačku i Austriju i Mađarsku ili ko zna koga, a sa naše strane mi nemamo koga da vučemo u rat. Mi smo im upozorili da su nam Rusi otvoreno rekli da oni ne mogu da nas pomognu.
Milosevic made it clear, the plan Lord Carrington was drawing up would allow Serbia to get what it wanted.
Sasvim je bilo jasno, i ta analiza i dan danas nije izgubila svoju aktuelnost, da je odluka i opredjeljenje da se plan prihvati.
The Carrington plan was the last proposal that tried to tackle all Yugoslavia's problems. It might have averted the bloodshed to come, not just in Croatia, but in Bosnia as well. Carrington sent his written plan to the Yugoslav presidents and summoned them back to The Hague.
Gospodin Carrington, vjerovatno se plašeći da ne bude kakvih proceduralnih zavrzlama od strane učesnika, konferencije i tako dalje, odmah je prišao na prvo poglavlje Haškog dokumenta i odmah je dao Slobodanu Miloševiću riječ.
And he raised all problems about legality, whether you could just dismember Yugoslavia, whether that was, I mean, everything that you could think of that he raised objection to. And it was quite clear that he was backpedaling.
Milosevic objected. Carrington's written plan had one seemingly minor but crucial change. Milosevic had said that Croatia could be independent, because he assumed he'd get what he desperately wanted, the other republics would stay in Yugoslavia. But now, Carrington's plan said each republic must first become sovereign and independent. Milosevic understood these words. They meant he would automatically lose his hold on the remaining republics.
A evo reći ću vam, to što je predloženo kao Haški dokument apsolutno nije mogla bude prihvatljivo.
It's very difficult really to make any judgment about why he felt so strongly about it from the arguments that he made. I mean the arguments were not valid.
jer su oni jednostavno tim haškim dokumentom, potezom pera, ukinuli Jugoslaviju. Na to oni nisu imali pravo.
For Milosevic, the continuation of Yugoslavia was essential. He had been willing to compromise over the Serbs in Croatia, but he was determined to keep the rest of the Serbs together. In his own Republic of Serbia and its tiny ally Montenegro, and the big prize, Bosnia, with 1.5 million Serbs. If he let Bosnia go, how would he then achieve his goal of a state for all Serbs?
I went round the table after Milosevic said no and asked all the others whether they were prepared to agree.
Prvo govori predstavnik Bosne I Hercegovine, zatim Hrvatske, Makedonije.
A Yugoslavia in which all the Serbs could live was shrinking before Milosevic's eyes. One by one, the other presidents approved the plan and voted for independence. Soon, Serbia would not have another republic to stay federated with. But Milosevic was safe. If just one other republic said they still wanted to be in Yugoslavia, the state could continue. He was sure he could count on his ally, the president of Montenegro. He was wrong.
Mi smo smatrali da je to sasvim dovoljno I da pruža mogućnost da ostvarimo svoje interese I da budu jednakopravno uvaženi interesi drugih. Bilo je to odlično sredstvo da se zaustavi rat.
To je izazvalo pravi jedan šok, jedno potpuno iznenađenje. U čitavoj sali je nastao tajac. Ja mislim da je muha prolazila negde tamo, čula bi se kako zuji. Koliko je to izazvalo iznenađenja u tom trenutku?
Milošević je bio dosta zbunjen I nervozan I prosto je bio u vrlo jednoj šokantnoj situaciji.
Wounded, Milosevic walked out of the meeting and called on his power base. He sent a clear message to the Serb people all over Yugoslavia.
Jer je reč o mogućnosti da se ta zemlja raspadne na više suverenih država koje dezintegrišu, ali dezintegrišu I narode. A mislim da bi to, pogotovo za srpski narod koji živi u nekoliko republika, imalo veoma teške posljedice.
Inače je to bila možda I najdublja politička kriza unutar naših rukovodstava.
The Serb leaders spent the flight home plotting.
Za nas je jedina povoljna verzija bila da Crna Gora povuče svoj stav.
I onda je počeo da zvoni moj telefon. Značajne političke ličnosti tamo pitali su je li moguće da si ti postao izdajnik srpskog naroda. Onda je taj razgovor trajao čitavu noć. Stalno su zvonili telefoni, već su počele pojedine prijetnje.
Narodna stranka Crne Gore zatražila je vanrednu sednicu crnogorskog parlamenta zbog toga što je Momir Bulatović potpisao haški dokument. Očekujemo da će njegov
usvoji njihovu deklaraciju kojom se potpis Momira Bulatovića na haški dokument osuđuje kao separatistička odluka kojom se deli jedinstvo.
Ja ne mogu zauzeti drugi stav nego da taj haški dokument ne potpiše.
Ako je kriterijum dobre vlasti u Crnoj Gori I od naroda prihvaćene vlasti, poslušnost I apsolutna identičnost s onim što dolazi iz Beograda, onda ovom narodu ne treba vlast.
But Montenegro was a Serb satellite. President Milosevic summoned the Montenegrin leader to his office in Belgrade.
Bakočević je direktno pitao kakvi su ishodi tih razgovora, da li su oni vama nešto obećali, nudili, da li su vam dali neku povoljniju poziciju nego da ostanete u Jugoslaviji.
In fact, the Italian foreign minister had held out a powerful incentive for the Montenegrins to abandon Serbia.
Era un programma importante, erano circa 30 o 40 miliardi di lire in vari progetti, che per il Montenegro, che ha 600.000 abitanti, era una questione importante. E dall'altro era interessato moltissimo ai rapporti di sviluppo economico con l'Europa, con la comunità europea e così via, e quindi con l'Italia, che riteneva il canale naturale del Montenegro verso l'Europa.
Bulatović je bio dosta kategoričan, rekao je jeste, imali smo razgovore I oni su nama obećavali I rekli su nam da ćemo biti na ličnoj dobiti.
The Serbs offered Bulatović a choice: face public scandal and political ruin, or send a letter to Carrington changing Montenegro's vote to a no on the plan.
I taj sastanak tekao dosta teško, nategnuto, sa dosta preznojavanja i Bulatovića i Đukanovića, i da su oni konačno, Bulatovića konačno prihvatio i napravili su taj tekst, potpisali ga i poslali gospodinu Carringtonu.
Ja sam poslije tog amandmana možda bio malo manji izdajnik nego što sam u prvom trenutku bio karakterisan.
The Carrington plan was now effectively dead. So Milosevic set about finishing his war in Croatia. He had secured most of the territory he wanted, but one city stubbornly held out. The Serb High Command sent its top general to take charge of the final assault on Vukovar.
I onda smo doneli odluku da ne bi osvajali kuću po kuću, nego da idemo osvajanjem Vukovara sa težim sredstvima naoružanja. Vukovar je stari grad, ima dosta kuća koje su pravljene od slabog materijala.
For 2 months, the Croats had made the Serbs fight every inch of the way into Vukovar. Stani. President Tudjman judged the city was lost. But Vukovar still had a role. Croatia had only one friend in Europe, Germany. To win recognition, it needed the sympathy of others.
Hrvatska je imala, kao što znate, veoma malo prijatelja za svoju samostalnost, sve do 91. Još potkraj 91. u vrijeme bitke za Vukovar.
The people of Vukovar were dependent on a thin trickle of supplies smuggled through enemy lines. Deliveries dried up. So the Croat commander decided to appeal personally to his president. He set off to walk through the encircling Serb army.
Imali smo sreću da je kišica padala i onako kao mala, mala sumaglica bila. Išli smo kroz kukuruze. Taj put je trajao sve skupa 13 sati. Nažalost, poginula su dvojica momaka i u tome razgovoru ja sam zahtijevao od predsjednika prije svega teško oružje.
I tražio sam da pod svaku cijenu dopreme minimalno pomoć Vukovaru onoliko koliko se to može.
But when the Croat commander got back to the front, no arms arrived. He then went before the press and accused his own leadership of sacrificing Vukovar to gain international sympathy.
Ja nisam nikada rekao da to nije slano. Pa ni sada neću to reći, da predsjednik nije poslao, ali čini se da mi to nismo dobili.
The Serbs were now certain to sack Vukovar. But the agony gave Germany a powerful argument inside the European community.
The Germans bludgeoned the rest of the community into recognizing the rebel republics. They'll recognize Slovenia and Croatia on Thursday, regardless.
Es hat sehr viel Spekulationen gegeben. Die Bundesregierung könne in dieser Frage isoliert sein. Aber es war eine sehr, sehr schwierige Verhandlung. Und ich sage, das Ergebnis übertrifft die Erwartungen, die wir hatten.
Vukovar finally fell to the Serbs. Now they controlled one third of Croatia. The cost to the two sides was 15,000 dead and 500,000 refugees. This is Vukovar, just after it fell.
Braneći Vukovar, mi smo branili Vinkovce i Osijek, jer da su Srbi uspjeli da laganije i brže osvoje Vukovar, to bi onda za Hrvatsku bilo znatno nepovoljnije. Zbog toga smo mi angažirali sve tada raspoložive snage.
At Vukovar, Yugoslavia's conscript army was hit with a rash of desertions. Milosevic had to bolster his forces with gangs of nationalist thugs.
Ovo je najjače ustaško uporište. Kad padne Vukovar, ustaše nemaju šansi. Razume se, onaj koji je došao ovdje dobrovoljno da se bori, taj zna zbog čega je došao i zašto se bori. Njega ne treba ubeđivati da ide u borbu.
Vrlo brzo smo stekli to povjerenje i onda nam je režim dao i kasarnu u Bubanj potoku. Čitava jedna kasarna je bila samo za dobrovoljce Srpske radikalne stranke.
The Carrington plan was now effectively dead. So Milosevic set about finishing his war in Croatia. He had secured most of the territory he wanted, but one city stubbornly held out. The Serb High Command sent its top general to take charge of the final assault on Vukovar.
I onda smo doneli odluku da ne bi osvajali kuću po kuću, nego da idemo osvajanjem Vukovara sa težim sredstvima naoružanja. Vukovar je stari grad, ima dosta kuća koje su pravljene od slabog materijala.
For 2 months, the Croats had made the Serbs fight every inch of the way into Vukovar. President Tudjman judged the city was lost. But Vukovar still had a role. Croatia had only one friend in Europe, Germany. To win recognition, it needed the sympathy of others.
Hrvatska je imala, kao što znate, veoma malo prijatelja za svoju samostalnost, sve do 1991. Još potkraj 1991. u vrijeme bitke za Vukovar.
The people of Vukovar were dependent on a thin trickle of supplies smuggled through enemy lines. Deliveries dried up. So the Croat commander decided to appeal personally to his president. He set off to walk through the encircling Serb army.
Imali smo sreću da je kišica padala i onako kao mala, mala sumaglica bila. Išli smo kroz kukuruze. Taj put je trajao sve skupa 13 sati. Nažalost, poginula su dvojica momaka i u tome razgovoru ja sam zahtijevao od predsjednika prije svega teško oružje.
i tražio sam da pod svaku cijenu dopreme minimalno pomoć Vukovaru onoliko koliko se to može.
But when the Croat commander got back to the front, no arms arrived. He then went before the press and accused his own leadership of sacrificing Vukovar to gain international sympathy.
Ja nisam nikada rekao da to nije slano. Pa ni sada neću to reći, da predsjednik nije poslao, ali je činjenica da mi to nismo dobili.
The Serbs were now certain to sack Vukovar. But the agony gave Germany a powerful argument inside the European community.
The Germans bludgeoned the rest of the community into recognizing the rebel republics. They'll recognize Slovenia and Croatia on Thursday, regardless.
Es hat sehr viel Spekulationen gegeben. Die Bundesregierung könne in dieser Frage isoliert sein. Aber es war eine sehr, sehr schwierige Verhandlung. Und ich sage, das Ergebnis übertrifft die Erwartungen, die wir hatten.
Vukovar finally fell to the Serbs. Now they controlled one third of Croatia. The cost to the two sides was 15,000 dead and 500,000 refugees. This is Vukovar just after it fell. Croatia. Croatia had lost a quarter of its territory to rebel Serbs. For 4 years, Croatia's president had been planning to seize it back.
Htjeli smo pokazati i svijetu da zaista raspolažemo sa vojnom snagom. Prema tome, htjeli smo i Srbima dati znati da je vrijeme da pristanu na mirno rješenje.
Built itself an army to crush the rebel Serbs. All they needed was the green light.
We did not think that that kind of an attack could do anything other than create a lot of refugees and cause a humanitarian problem. On the other hand, it always had the prospect of simplifying matters.
We knew a few days before the operation that it was in fact going to occur. I went down to meet with President Tudjman to deliver a demarche.
We are concerned by indication that you are preparing for an offensive in sectors south and north.
We made clear to Tudjman that we did not favor military action.
Nakon ovakvog ozbiljnog upozorenja, koje se razumije se da sam ja najozbiljnije razmotrio, nisam odustao. Ja sam bio uvjeren da mi možemo postići pobjedu.
Tudjman had read the signals well. 3 days later, his army began shelling the rebel Serbs' capital, Knin. The Croats had a huge advantage in men and armor. They rolled in with ease. The Serb soldiers had already fled.
Come on, come on, come on, come on.
Once again, a centuries-old community was uprooted. This time, more than 100,000 Serbs from Croatia. They had stuck by a regime based on ethnic cleansing. Now they paid the price.
Čini se jednostavno da je velik broj ljudi odraslog srpskog pučanstva bio uključen u tu te srpske paravojne snage, a drugi dio pučanstva da je bio obmanut, da evo da dolaze ustaše, fašisti i da im nema drugo nego da bježe.
To make sure the Serbs never returned, Tudjman's army set their villages alight. They murdered hundreds of old people who'd hung stubbornly on.
Mislio sam da će 60-70% Srba ostati, da će shvatiti da je to demokratska Hrvatska koja im jamči građanska i etnička prava. Prema tome, sami su Srbi odgovorni za takvu sudbinu kao što su je doživjeli.
President Tudjman had achieved an ethnically pure Croatia.
Zastava ovdje znači dovršenje djela uspostave slobodne nezavisne Hrvatske.